Have you ever seen a skyscraper? These giant buildings let us save space by building up instead of out. But how do these skyscrapers go so high without falling over? Sofia Puerto, a civil engineer, can tell us how.
When designing a skyscraper, engineers face two main challenges. One is the weight of the skyscraper, because the more floors you have in a skyscraper, the heavier it will be and the more challenging it will be to design the foundation.
As the skyscraper gets bigger and bigger, the weight of the skyscraper increases. Engineers need to be careful when choosing their materials and the way they use their materials, so buildings are light and strong.
And the other one is the wind. Using trusses in a skyscraper could provide stiffness or make it stronger without adding too much weight when adding floors.
A truss is a triangle-shaped structure usually made out of steel that uses tension and compression forces to give support to a building.
But why are trusses so great? Trusses are able to provide additional strength and stiffness to the building while being very lightweight. Did you know that the triangle is one of the most stable shapes in geometry? Try making a rectangle with your fingers and try pushing them together. What happens? Now make a triangle with your fingers and push on them. What happens? You can see that triangles are a very stable shape. They are able to withstand a lot of force without moving. The triangle has a balance of forces, specifically compression and tension, that make it so stable.
Wind is one of the things an engineer has to watch out for when building and designing a skyscraper. The taller the building is, the stronger the pulling and pushing forces are. So the building has to be flexible enough to move back and forth without breaking.
Start building your skyscraper on Curiosity Machine. How high in the sky will you go?